Hello, welcome to the project deployment tutorial for EcoStruxure Energy Hub. In this second chapter, deployment of Energy Hub, we will see how to deploy an Energy Hub system from site to organization level. In this topic, alarms and notifications, we will learn about the different types of alarms in EcoStruxure Energy Hub, their availability based on specific subscriptions, devices, and architecture, and how to configure them. Before getting started, first, make sure you are logged in to Energy Hub and have completed the basic settings, with any of the subscriptions activated for your organization. To get the full spectrum of alarms, plus advanced subscription is recommended. Please watch the videos on Energy Hub basic settings and energy hierarchy and settings to know more. Alarms help us to stay informed or notified about any exceptional operating conditions in your site or organization. It could be a measurement exceeding a defined value, or a disruption in normal operating conditions. An alarm can be raised by a monitoring device, a communication gateway, or the Energy Hub software. The availability of these alarms within your organization depends on various factors, including the type of devices, gateways, and subscription. For the detailed list of alarms and their characteristics, please refer the Energy Hub Help documentation. In Home, you can see the total number of unacknowledged alarms for the organization. The alarm information is available in Investigate Asset View. The Asset View shows alarm information for the device or location that you select in the organization tree. But Inbox serves as a central repository for all notifications that you have configured in the notification settings for your entire organization. This includes alarms, subscription-related notifications, etc. In both, you can see alarm summary and individual alarm details. The alarm summary view can be filtered based on category, priority, and alarm state in Asset View. And in Inbox, it can be filtered based on alarm state and date range. Alarm information will show the category, type, detail, priority, state, along with the start end times and duration. Alarm state could be active or inactive and acknowledged or unacknowledged. Click on Investigate Alarm Source to go to the location where the alarm originated and analyze the details. You can acknowledge an active or inactive alarm. When you acknowledge an alarm, Energy Hub records the username of the logged-in user, the date and time of the acknowledgement, and an optional comment. Acknowledging any one instance of the alarm acknowledges all other unacknowledged instances of the same alarm. Alarms in Energy Hub are classified depending upon their source of generation and application category. Based on the application category, there are diagnostics, energy management, power quality, and asset monitoring alarms. And based on the origin, there are three types of alarms: communication alarms, device alarms, and software alarms. In communication alarms, we have device communication loss and gateway communication loss alarms. These alarms do not require an active subscription and become available once the gateway is added to your site. They fall under the application category of diagnostics. When the communication between a device and the gateway is lost, then a communication loss alarm is generated with low priority. Start time of this alarm is based on the device settings in the gateway, which is usually in few minutes. Accordingly, when the communication between gateway and Energy Hub is lost, a gateway communication loss alarm is generated with high priority. This alarm activates only when communication is interrupted for more than 4 hours, in order to minimize nuisance alarms caused by intermittent network availability commonly associated with cellular routers. Next is the device alarms. These are alarms originating from the measurement or protection devices at site and generated and published by the gateway to Energy Hub. The publishing time to Energy Hub for these alarms is up to 60 seconds for the panel server and under 30 seconds for the site server. This may vary depending on the latency in customer network and internet speed. To utilize most device alarms, except for PowerTag Energy and Ambient, your organization needs a Plus Advanced subscription. Additionally, the availability of these alarms depends on specific devices and gateways at the site. For the detailed list of device alarms and their recommended architecture, please refer the Energy Hub Help documentation. Let's see few device alarms. If PowerTag Energy Sensor with Panel Server is at site, it gives overcurrent 80% and voltage loss alarms. These alarms come in the category of power quality. When the current value exceeds 80% of the nominal current of the sensor, overcurrent 80% alarm is generated with medium priority. And when the voltage becomes zero, the voltage loss alarm is generated with high priority. If the PowerTag Energy Sensor is installed at the load side, voltage loss means a possible breaker trip. Breaker alarms, Acti9 auxiliary status alarms through SmartLink, and heat tag alarms are some additional examples of device alarms. Next is software alarms. These alarms are configured in Energy Hub by the user with the required thresholds and priority for any supported devices or elements in hierarchy. In this we have equipment and ambient temperature alarms, which falls into the category of asset monitoring, and average voltage, average current, active power, and power factor alarms, which belongs to the category of power quality. These alarms use log data, so the evaluation period taken by Energy Hub to check the measured value against the thresholds depend upon the gateway publication interval. For example, it is 10 minutes for panel server. This may vary depending on the latency in customer network and internet speed. We also have energy, water, and gas consumption alarms for applicable devices, which falls into the category of energy management. Here we can set the observation interval as daily, weekly, monthly, or yearly as required. For these alarms, the evaluation period is hourly. The essential and advanced subscription includes alarms for energy, water, and gas consumption. The Plus Advanced subscription offers all software alarms. For setting energy consumption alarm at site level, go to Investigate. In the Navigation panel, click on the site. In the Information panel, click Alarm Settings. Add Alarm Rule. Select Energy Consumption. Click Next. Please note, the alarm settings are as per active energy, irrespective of the energy mode you had selected earlier. Let's select Interval. Daily. Priority medium. Provide the daily threshold when we need this alarm to be on. Give the rule a name. Toggle the switch to on or off to enable or disable the alarm. Finish. Similarly, you can set a monthly or yearly overconsumption alarm. Either you can provide separate monthly targets or provide a single yearly target. Provide the thresholds in percentage of target, where you want to generate the alarms, and set the priority. If you are providing the yearly target, it will be equally divided to monthly targets automatically. Go to Home to see the sites and their performance against the set target. Similarly, you can set the other software alarms as per your desired thresholds and priority. Finally, let's see how to get these alarms as notifications. Energy Hub can send notifications about subscriptions and alarm state changes to your Schneider ID email account, and it can send push notifications to your mobile device through the Energy Hub mobile app. There is a limit of 100 email notifications per device credit per month, but no limit on the mobile push notifications. You can customize these options within the notification settings to meet the specific needs of each user. In Setup, Notification Settings, you can customize the settings based on alarm category and alarm priority to get email notification or mobile push notifications. You can access the inbox to quickly view alarms and other notifications for your entire organization based on your configured settings. Congratulations! You have completed the alarms and notification settings for your organization. Thanks for watching this video. Please watch the next videos in the project deployment series to easily deploy your EcoStruxure Energy Hub system.